Hey guys, this is going to be a tutorial on how to make this very adorable bow holder. So if you're interested in learning how to make one, then stay tuned. So for this project, you're going to need paper towels. You're going to need some scissors, a picture frame. You're going to need a paper plate with a sponge brush. You can use a paintbrush, but they're kind of expensive and these are only like 43 cents at Walmart. And you're going to need some paint, a paper plate, some glue, a pencil, some scrapbooking paper, and some ribbon. It sounds like a lot, but it's actually not. It's really easy. So let's get started. So the first thing you're going to do is paint your frame. That way when it's dry, you can get your other stuff for it out of the way and it's just easier. So I got this pearl paint. It's very pretty and it has like a pearlescent tone to it. So I gave it a shot. Here's what it looks like on the plate. You can kind of see it's very pearly. So the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to paint your frame. And there's not really a rhyme or reason to this. All I suggest is that you start and paint in the same direction. Don't just paint like this. So I decided to go horizontally. And that way there's no weird streaking. So I'm just going to keep on painting this, like so. And it's okay if it gets in the center because we're going to paint that anyways. So, and you can absolutely paint the sides and the back if you chose to. I'm not going to paint the back just because it's going to be hanging and so nobody's going to see it, but I am going to paint obviously the front and then the inside of this and the outer rims so that way everybody can see it. But I'm going to paint this and then I'm going to let it dry and then I'm going to paint on another coat. So once I finish painting that, I will come back and show you what it looks like and we will get going on the next part of the craft. Okay guys, so my frame is now painted, as you can see, and it's dry. So the next thing I'm going to do is I got the heart-shaped frame and it came with this cutout. So all I did is on the back of my scrapbook paper, it's little hearts, I just traced the heart, and now I'm going to cut it out so it's the exact shape of the picture. So I'm going to go ahead and cut that out. Okay, now that my heart is cut out, now you're just going to put your picture into your frame, like so. It fits really nicely, and obviously if you have a square frame, you don't have to cut out, you could just cut down the paper to fit. And I would definitely recommend getting a higher quality frame. I'm gonna do this again with one that has glass, so that way it's like super duper nice. I mean, not that this isn't nice, but you know, it was at Walmart for like a dollar, so. So there it is. There's our beginning part. So now what we're going to do is attach the ribbons for the bows and the handle. So I'm going to move this. I'm still going to keep this on the paper towel just in case, because you never know. So what I'm going to do is I have this pretty pink ribbon and I'm going to cut it evenly. Of course, because you don't want staggered ends, but I'm just going to cut this off here. There we go. So, and you obviously want your ribbon to be a good size. You can't have it too thick or the bows won't clip on evenly, and you don't want it to be too thin because it won't, the quality will be kind of weird. So what you want to do is take your ribbon and kind of just measure how long you want it to be. I think about here is good. So I'm going to cut that much off and just cut it. I like to cut it on a slant. I think it makes it look prettier. And then I'm going to just match them up here. I always take the bottom with the top because that way it's even and so you can match it really well. And then just smooth it down like this. Just do this a couple times just to make sure that there's no folds or lines, creases, anything like that. Okay, then I'm gonna go ahead and cut. There we go. And there we have it. There's where our bows are gonna be clipped. And then I'm gonna take another. And you don't really need to measure this. You can kind of just guesstimate how long you want your handle to be, because you just want it to go like this on top of your bow handle. So now comes the part of gluing the ribbon on. So I'm going to turn it around. I hope you guys can see. And then I'm going to take my glue. And you can do more than two strands. Let's see. I want to make sure that I think I can do three. Yeah, I'll do three. So I'm going to grab my ribbon again because I decided to do three at last minute. And I'm going to match them up again. Someone's impatient outside if you can hear that. Alright. So there. Now for our third strand. So to glue it, like I said, I'm going to get my glue out, and sometimes this explodes, so make sure you have your paper plate at close hand, especially when the pressure, see how it's exploding a little bit? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my ribbon and make sure that the shiny part is facing down, because that's going to show on the board. So the dull part is up, the shiny part is down if you have shiny ribbon. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a generous amount of my glue and glue it on my board. Then I'm going to take my ribbon and place it in the glue. And I take my dowel so that way my fingers don't get gluey. And just glue it down. Like so. And you want to make sure that it's even. Like that. So that way it doesn't glue crooked. So you don't want a crooked bow holder. Okay, that's it. So now we're going to do the next one. It's very simple. And of course you want to make sure that they're lined up evenly. Like that. It looks hard, but it's really not, guys, I promise. So. And then, of course, if you want to make adjustments, you can just move it. Like this. Just move it down. Or what have you. And then our last one. And obviously, you want to make sure that they're even. That looks pretty even. And press press it down. And then while the glue is still wet, I like to take that first piece that we cut off and cut off little sections. Just three will do. Oops. There we go. And use those to cover the part that we glued, just for extra like reinforcement. And you can add more glue if you wish. I'm going to add a little bit more to this one. Okay, so just glue this down. Just to make sure we have extra, because the bows can get heavy. And so you want to make sure that they're secure. And again, I did shiny side up just because it looks prettier. So, there's what it looks like. Just want to make sure that it's even. Looks pretty good. Okay, now, and it also helps with it moving, like swaying, because it's glued down. Now, I'm going to take my other piece, and again, make sure that the shiny side is up, and you're just going to see roughly where you want it to go up here. I know it's hard to see, guys. I'm sorry. But you just pull it up like that. Make it like an upside down U or a frowny face. And then just take your glue. And I do like a longer line instead of just a dab. And then place it on. And there we go. So I'm going to take this last piece because it's perfect amount and I don't want to waste, and put my reinforcements on there. Fix that up a little bit. There. And then slap that baby right there. And then I hold it down for a little bit. Alright, so now that this is all put together, I'm just going to wait for it to dry. So that was it. It's so simple. I promise I'm gonna make a new video when I make a different one, and hopefully it'll be a little bit better quality and I'll do different angles and stuff. But I just wanted to show you a really quick and easy way to make a bow holder. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thanks so much for watching. Bye.